For the teenage age group, essentially you may not see significant difference from, I mean, between the sexes, because usually the pattern of behavior is essentially the same. Things like running away from school, you know, not meeting up with schoolwork, going late to school, for example, and staying late beyond the normal curfew period. Someone that's supposed to be at home by Maghrib, for example, whatever it is, starts coming home after Isha or even later. You know that there is something this person is doing beyond the normal time that has been allotted for, for socializing outside, whatever. Then again, you realize that things start getting missing in the house, for example, because this group of individuals are not working. They don't earn money. They depend on the pocket money you give them or the spending money you give them. But then you start noticing that small items in the house get missing without being accounted for. So where is it gone to? They start pilfering things in the house, either to pawn for the drugs or to sell and have money to be able to maintain this behavior. And of course, eating pattern changes. Some, especially with the, under the influence of cannabis, they tend to overeat, you know. Then those who use alcohol tend to undereat, you know. So when there's a significant change in eating pattern, you must be wary of what is happening. Then again, it might actually be a pointer to a mood disorder. Maybe the person is having some form of depression or even mania, as the case may be. You know, mania is almost like the opposite of depression, you know, where the mood is elevated. The person is excessively happy, loses all sorts of inhibition. So sometimes this drug, what you observe as a change in behavior may actually be a mood problem that needs a doctor's attention immediately. However, some drugs also mimic this by their effect. So one needs to be sure that this is not as a result of drug use and it's actually a real mental health issue that is going on. However, drug use too is also a mental health issue. So that's where we talk of the issue of comorbidity too. Now, apart from all this, you realize that the person, for example, doesn't keep meet up with time of Salat, as usual. You know, why is this so? Salat used to be something that is timed and important in the person's life. Now, this individual has found a replacement social activity, such that, for example, someone that drinks will not feel comfortable to go and pray. So he starts skipping Salat because he knows that, if he prays, it doesn't mean anything anyway, you know. So those behavioral changes will be what you start noticing, but this boy is learned. Why is he doing this? So it calls for you to take action at that point. Call them to order or even take them and walk them to a therapist and say, look, let's have this investigation done, you know. So when he knows that eyes are on him or her, they're likely to probably withdraw and retrace their step, you know. So those are the kind of things you just watch out for. Significantly, a change in behavior from the usual pattern. Once you start noticing things, they may be subtle. Like I said earlier, some might start staying longer in the toilet. You start wondering what is happening, you know. So all these things are things you need to look out for. They are not cast in gold, but then they are common things that you can easily take note if you are alert. You always take note that something has changed in this person. Investigate. Don't just wish it aside like, it's one of these teenage things. There's a lot of things that happen in teenage age. Drug use is one of them. So you don't want to miss that.